Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. My dear students, today we will discuss our chapter unit number 1, chapter number 1, science skills, week number 9, science, grade 6. In this chapter we will see that what is science and laboratory safety, hazards and risk, and taking measurements. All these are very, very important topics, so listen them carefully. The objective of today's lesson is that we will be able to differentiate between the different fields of the science and related to the application in their daily life. And we will also be able to observe the safety measures with due regards for the potential hazards arising from their work. We will also be able to take the measurements accurately using appropriate measuring instrument. Now, there are few questions to wake up, and these are the questions of the brainstorming. Have you ever wondered how a machine works? कभी आपके जहन में ख्याल आया कि मशीन कैसे काम करती है? माइक आपने ऑन नहीं करना. आई विल रिप्लाई माई सेल्फ. मशीन वर्क्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ द एनर्जी फ्यूल इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. दैट फ्यूल मे बी इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, दैट मे बी डीजल पेट्रोल. इन दिस वे द मशीन वर्क्स मीन्स एनर्जी इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर अ मशीन टू वर्क. वी ऑल्सो नीड एनर्जी. हम इंसानों को भी, ह्यूमन बींग्स को भी एनर्जी की ज़रूरत होती है. जैसे कि अभी आप नाश्ता करके बैठे हुए, दैट्स वाई यू आर एबल टू लिसन. हैव यू एवर सीन अ साइंस लेबॉर्ट्री? इफ़ यू हैव सीन, दैट्स गुड. अगर नहीं देखी तो कोई बात नहीं. वैन द स्कूल विल बी ओपन, दैन वी विल गो टू द साइंस लेबॉर्ट्री. वट इज़ योर वेट एंड हाइट? ओके, इट इज़ योर टास्क. यू हैव टू टेल योर वेट एंड हाइट. You can tell in the same session or in the next week as well. As how did you know about your physical, about these physical quantities? आपको कैसे पता चलता है physical quantities का? Like अगर मामा कहती हैं कि जो है ना आपने आप sugar buy करें, ठीक है ना, तो आपको क्या पता चलेगा कि that how much sugar you want? Definitely you have to tell the units. आप उसको बताओगे कि 1 kilogram sugar is required, then the shopkeeper will give you the 1 kilogram sugar. Otherwise, he will be unable to give you. What is science? Science is about obtaining knowledge by observation and experimentation, and using that knowledge to describe and explain natural things. Science helps us to understand the world around us, solve problems, and to retain. ट्रेन आर माइंड्स टू थिंक लॉजिकली. साइंस हमें सोचने पर मजबूर करती है, लॉजिकल और रीजनिंग आंसर्स जो है वो ढूंढने की तरफ जो है वो हमें हमारा माइंड लेके जाती है. तो इट इज़ बेस्ड ऑन द ऑब्जर्वेशंस एंड एक्सपेरिमेंट्स. साइंस हैज़ 3 मेन एरियाज. मीन्स अप टिल नाउ यू हैव सीन दैट देर वॉज 1 बुक ऑफ साइंस, बट नाउ इन क्लास 6 वी हैव डिवाइडेड दैम इन टू 3 मेन एरियाज, बायोलॉजी, केमिस्ट्री एंड फिजिक्स. Dear students, biology, bio means life and logi means study. Means it is a Greek word, biology, and bio means life and logi means study. Study of the living thing is called the biology. It is the study of the living world around us. It covers everything from what goes on inside the bodies of the animals and plants to the natural environment. And we will divide it into the biotechnology and microbiology. Biotechnology, bio means life and technology means techniques which we use for the life, like to save the life of the humans, which techniques we use, it is called the biotechnology. If we are thinking about the animals and plants, they also need some techniques, scientific techniques, to save their life, to make them good, productive, and to increase their quantity and amount as well as, and to make them more strong, more healthy, we use biotechnology. Microbiology. Microbiology is also combination of the 3 words. Micro means small, bio means life, and logi means study. Study of the small living things is called the microbiology. Humans, plants, animals are visible to you, but the small organisms like virus, bacteria, and algae, they are not visible to you. They are micro in size. You cannot see them with the naked eye. That's why they are called the microorganisms. And the study of the microorganisms is called the microbiology. Chemistry is the second department of the science. It is the study of all substances that make a physical world around us. It covers the physical properties and the reaction of all the elements and compounds we found on the earth. You have seen many different things around you, like you are familiar with different gases, with different elements around you, like carbon, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide. These are all elements and compounds, as well as like common salt, NaCl, which we, is also called the table salt. So all these elements, they do react with each other. And the study of the chemical reaction among the elements is called the chemistry. Petrochemical industry and pharmaceutical industry, these are the two examples of the chemistry. Petrochemical means jo cheezein petroleum se banti hain, and it is called the petrochemical industry. Pharmaceutical company means isme medicines banti hain, theek hai. Physics, it is the third branch of the third main branch of the science. It is the study of the physical world around us. It covers everything from the nature of the tiny particles that make up atoms to the laws that controls the galaxies. Electronics and information technology, these are the example of the physics. My dear students, in junior classes, you have only the book of the science. You were having only the book of science because that was the junior level and the knowledge was limited. But as much as you will move to the higher classes, then the what will happen, the information, the knowledge will expand. So what the teachers, they have did, publishers, they have did, they have divided your book into the three portions. Some content will be from the physics, some will be from the biology, and some from the physics, chemistry. So you have to remember that which topic is from the physics, which topic is from the chemistry, and which from the biology. The topics which are related to the life, like plants, animals, and humans, they come in the biology. The topics which are related to the chemical reactions, they will come in the chemistry. And the topics which are related to the galaxy and the particles around us, forces of attraction, they all come in the physics. Laboratory safety activity. Write the things that you see students are doing wrong in this picture. You have 5 minutes for this task. My dear students, what you have to do after this session, you have to observe this diagram and you have to write that what are the wrong things in this laboratory. Laboratory is actually the room, it is actually the activity room where you have to do the experiments. And you know that for the experiment you have to be more vigilant, more clear, more having more patience as well as. There are some rules and regulations for the laboratory. Science laboratory rules, you have to be responsible in the lab. You have to follow the instructions. You have to ask the question if you have any query in your mind instead of touching the instruments by yourself. You have to wear the protective gears, like you have to wear the goggles. You have to wear the gloves. You have to wear the lab coat. Use chemicals and glasswares properly, means don't handle them carelessly. Never fool around in the lab. And keep work areas clean, because if they will, it will be messy, then you will have a problem. Dress properly. No eating in the lab. Eating is not allowed in the lab. Okay, remember this thing, because you have to be more vigilant over there instead of doing some foolish activities. Hazards and risks. What are the hazards and risks in the laboratory? A hazard is something that dangerous and could cause injury and ill health, damage to the property or the environment. For example, concentrated acid means hazard means जो आपको आपके लिए dangerous है. Those are harmful to you. And risk is the chance that hazard may actually cause harm. It is important to assess the risk of the harm when carrying out an experiment and to take the precautions to work safely. That is why a hazard warning symbol are put on the container of the warning. Now these are the diagrams which will help you out to understand hazard, water, gasoline, driving, risk, jumping in without knowing how to swim, lighting a match, and texting means gaadi chala rahe hain, aap mobile pe message kar rahe hain, so it is a risk. You know how to drive, but if you are texting in the driving, so it may cause a harmful effect on your driving. It may cause the accident. These are the hazard symbols and their meanings are written there, and description is also given. Toxic, can cause death. For example, if swallowed, breathed in, or absorbed by the skin. This sign shows the corrosive, attacks and destroys the living tissues such as skin and eyes. Oxidizing, provides oxygen to make other substances burn more fiercely. Serious health hazards, cause is allergic reactions, may cause cancer, may cause genetic defects and may cause damage to the fertility and unborn child, causes damage to the organs. Flammable, catches fire easily. Explosive, explodes due to the fire, shock friction or heat catches the fire easily. Harmful to the environment. Harmful to the environment and harmful, toxic to the things with the long lasting effects. Okay ji, next is beta, these are the signs which helps you out to understand their meanings. Like the road signs we have, the road signs also help us to drive on the road safely. So if suppose the labor is working, then before it there will be a sign that labor is working ahead, slow your speed, and this signboard will helps you out to slow your speed. Otherwise what will happen, you will go with the same speed and accident may happen over there. So like this, in the laboratory some symbols are pasted and which helps you out to understand that what it does mean. Did you know what is a risk assessment? Risk assessment means you know the you know that you don't know. You know, like you know the driving, but if you are talking on the mobile or texting on it, then your life is at the risk. You know that you don't know how to swim, even then you are jumping in the water. It is your at life risk. Now we are moving towards the new topic, taking measurements. When we don't have to depend on our senses to make the observation, we can use the measuring instrument instead. Jab hamari senses kaam nahi karti, sense hamari sense kya kaam karti hai, touch, feel or smell, listening and taste as well. As sometimes we are unable to tell the exact temperature, body temperature. Suppose someone is having god forbid fever, doctor ne fever pucha kitna hai ji, aap waise to nahi bata sakte, ye to nahi keh sakte bahut zyada hai ya bahut kam hai. What you will do the instrument over there, thermometer you will use to tell the exact temperature of the body. Same is the case when we will go to the shopkeeper and ask for a cloth. The shopkeeper will definitely say that, tell me the measurement, that how much length you need. So suppose I need 4 meter, the shopkeeper will give you the 4 meter cloth. But without length, it is not possible for the shopkeeper to give you or to give you the services as well as volume. Length, we use instrument for the following measurements, like the length, volume, mass, temperature and time. What is volume? Length to samajh mein aa gayi, that this is, will be the length. Volume is actually the measurement of the liquid that we use the measuring cylinder for it. So we will see it one by one. First of all, I will discuss length with you. It is its measuring instrument is a ruler or tape measure. Tape measure and ruler are used to measure the length of any object. Units are kilometer, meter and centimeter. Centimeter is the smallest unit, then meter and kilometer is the largest unit. Volume, its measuring instrument is the cylinder. Measuring cylinder is the measuring instrument of it, and we measure it volume of any regular object by V is equal to length into breadth into height. This is the formula which we use to measure the volume of a regular object. My dear students, here I am again saying a regular object, and for measuring the irregular object volume, what we will do, check the diagram. There is a measuring cylinder, empty measuring cylinder on the left hand side. First of all, we will take the water in it and then we will note the reading. Suppose the reading is here 15.2, okay. So, and by adding the irregular object in the measuring cylinder, we will see that there will be the rise in the water level, and that is 20. So what we will do here, we will minus 20, we will minus 15.2 from the 20, then we will get the volume of the regular object, irregular object, and the units are liter, milliliter. Now I think the length and the volume is clear to you. I am moving towards the next slide. It is about the mass and temperature. This is measuring scale. In the diagram or in the picture you are watching right now, measuring scale or weighing scale, it is also called, or electronic balance, it is also called electronic balance, okay. And the units of the mass are grams and kilograms. Grams are the units, smaller units, and kilograms are the larger units. Temperature. Temperature. How you can define temperature? You can define temperature that degree of hotness and coldness is called temperature. Mass ko kaise define karenge? Quantity of matter in an object is called the mass. And we use thermometer. There are two different types of the thermometers are shown. The units of the thermometer are temperature are degree Celsius and degree Fahrenheit and Kelvin. Mostly we use degree Celsius, and Kelvin is the international unit over here. Now this slide tells us about the time. Its measuring instrument is stopwatch and stop clock. The units of the time are hours, minutes and seconds. What are SI units? Dear students, SI units means system of international units. How we need and why we need system of international units? Because previously in the past, people were using different measuring instruments and measuring units for measuring the different things. But later on, due to the certain problems ki ek hi cheez ko different cheez se measure kiya ja raha hai, uska unit bhi different hai, the scientists, they took a serious note of it that they must have the same measuring instrument and same units. For this, they have developed a system of international units, and all these units and measuring instruments are placed in the France. There is a lab where they kept all the international instruments over there, and they are the standard one, and we all are following that. Activity time. Measure the length of the pencils or pen with a ruler. You can do it later on. You must have a scale at your home, and you can measure the length of the pencil or anything around you, and you can discuss with me during the question answer session and in the next lesson as well. As written work, this is the written work. Test yourself, page number 5, question 1, 2, 3, 4. Test yourself, page number 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. Exercise 3, 4. Questions are mentioned over here, and the activity is to measure the height of their family members and keep a record of it. Record of the result activity form in the form of the table. Recommended websites. These are the recommended website for the laboratory safety and taking measurements. You can go and watch these links. Recap. In today's lecture, we have learned about the science and its branches. Up till now, we have learned about the science and branches. Science is the study of the nature, having the reasoning study of the law about the nature. It has three main branches, physics, biology, and chemistry. I have discussed all these with you in detail. After this, we have discussed the laboratory safety and their rules. Hazards and risks. What are hazards and what are risks? The pictures have been shown to you so that the difference between them must be clear to you. After this, we did a very important topic. It was about the taking important measurements. Thank you for your patience. Now it is a question answer session. Dear students,